Okay, Nick's in the house. Let's roll.
Good morning, Dr. Lucas. You have 3 new messages from Supervisor Gutier.
Chill, bro. We're not machines. Shh. Oops. Sorry.
Dr. Lucas, you have 4 messages from Supervisor...
I'm an artist, bro. I can't do a thing before my morning coffee, okay?
Supervising Gattier here.
Or maybe I can.
You're behind schedule, Dr. Lucas.
Oh, we're ready to beta test those biomes. Sweet. Was tired of covering for those physics guys. Guess I don't need these stupid gloves today.
Guess you keep that smart interface on and bring your stupid self to work, Dr. Lucas.
Aye, aye, ma'am. Which biome shall I prioritize?
I don't care, Lucas. You're going to test all of them today, or I'll make sure they kick you back to Earth in your next performance appraisal. So just pick one and get going.
Thanks for the feedback, Supervisor. I think I'm going to...
Did I say I care, Lucas? And did I? No. I said I don't care. Get a move on, you lazy Terran.
Jeez, boss girl has zero chill. Let me pick a track and get started before she goes ballistic.
Warning. As per AEGIR protocols, tests must be completed in batches. Should you quit one of the testing areas before completing the full set of puzzles, said area will be automatically reset.
Oh, come. Really?
You know the research protocol, Doctor.
Oh, come on. Really?
You can talk back to the machine, but not to me, Lucas. Get down on it.
Oh, it's human. Ugh. Reminds me of the launch pad at Amapá. I bet they make you sweat before you board the ship to shave some weight off the human cargo.
We are interested in the viability of a dome-based rainforest environment, not your grievances about space shuttles.
Yeah, I get it. AEGIR wants to grow produce up here. The orbital statelets will buy anything as long as it's not from Filipino Terra, right?
This is a research lab. We follow guidelines. We achieve results. We do not speculate about the commercial strategies of AEGIR Labs Corporation.
Thank you.
deploying this biome on Faustini, Dr. Lucas.
Faustini? Respectfully, that's a bad idea. My prime candidate would be Sverdrup. Conditions are optimal. Just a little tweak to the mirrors, perhaps some fine-tuning to the gas inputs, but we're talking minor adjustments.
I'll log your suggestion. The tourism and hospitality branch has a seaside resort planned, and this biome will be part of...
Seaside? You're making a sea out there? I thought you were doing science?
Science at this scale is not exactly cheap, Lucas. Something has to pay for it. Someone.
Let me guess. Some nouveau riche from the orbital statelets.
Wrong. Old money running away from Terra, actually. Your betters, Lucas. Nobody wants to live on your overheated, flooded rock anymore. Those who can afford it are jumping ship.
Thank you.
So, what about the orchids?
Which ones? We have about 300 species of bulbophyllum.
Hospitality wants the...
Eoniria caelum magna, a custom-engineered variety, patented by Latte for genomics in 67, banned from Terra for the addictive narcotics in its pollen.
Our VIPs have extremely rarefied tastes in gardening.
1 minute I'm working on making the moon green, the biggest bio project in history. And the next one I'm making magic flowers for rich junkies?
Lucas!
Oh, you have your dreamland orchids.
I just had confirmation of the deployment to Svedru.
That's pretty good news.
Naturally, you'll be held accountable for the results, as per the performance tracking clause of your contract.
It's nice to feel valued.
Thank you. With that in mind, I am rating your satisfaction with my management as 9 out of 10. Don't waste too much time on this biome, Dr. Lucas. It's a low-profit project.
It's a bit late for that. We're already in Alpha. And may I add, profit considerations aside, from a biological point of view, a boreal environment is quite a challenge. And proof of concept that we can bring life to the furthest reaches of...
Chop, chop, Lucas! We might still hit today's quota.
On it, ma'am.
So, what's your assessment?
The coal ecosystem is showing great resilience. What do you need it to do?
That's outside your need-to-know area.
Ski slopes, bear hunting, some other frivolity for rich assholes.
Only one way to find out, Doctor.
Yeah?
Become rich.
Sure. Any day now.
Too slow. Average productivity is down, Lucas.
Whatever, boss girl.
What?
On it, supervisor. Almost done, Supervisor Ngatie. Just one to go.
Finally.
Respectfully, you're not the one who has to do the hard work in sub-zero temperatures.
I am also. also not the one who is on probation, whose name is on a one-way ticket back to Terra.
Subtle as an orbital strike, Supervisor Gatti. I'm actually very proud of that Arctic biome.
A fine testimonial for our next newsletter.
Thank you.
to be honest. I never understood how this biome got approved by hospitality. Who wants to live in a desert?
Terrans, apparently.
Do they now? I'm from Terra, and this does nothing for me.
You're from the wrong hemisphere, Lucas. The point of this biome being, it's nice and dry. As in not flooded. How's the tactile feedback, Lucas?
Mostly fine. Sometimes it feels a little bit loose when using the, blue stuff.
Feels loose when using blue stuff. More insights?
Sort of dingly at times. Sometimes it gives you these little static shocks if you shoot it too fast.
Tingly when... Don't just stand there, Lucas. Move on.
Things sure make your hands sweaty.
Didn't need to know that. Keep testing those gloves for me, Lucas, will you? My task list goes 3 times around Luna.
On it.
We need to...
I said I'm on it. pocket Grand Canyon is ready for deployment.
Not a minute too soon, Lucas.
All readings green. Seems to be adapting pretty well to the low G.
Start testing that interface, Dr. Lucas.
Respectfully, Supervisor Ngatier, my field is habitats bioengineering. I fail to see why I'm being tasked with...
It's not your only failing, Dr. Lucas. I suggest you waste no more time on comments.
Fine.
you to the next one.
What? No toilet breaks?
Your contract specifies your services as a bioengineer. I see no comedian addendum here.
Not that you appreciate it anyway. We have a great test batch for a deciduous forest here. I can't wait to see it thrive out there in the wild.
A pressurized, artificially lighted, heated, and biomanaged dome is not what I'd call wild. AEGIR Labs is investing billions in this lunar-forming initiative. You make it sound like we're just spraying seeds around.
It's a figure of speech. Moving on to the last bit. I need to check chlorophyll density levels.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm no physicist, but these gravitonic effects seem pretty impressive. When did Aegir develop these?
You never wore those. You never heard a single thing about that experimental interface.
Oh, come on. You can tell me. I've signed the NDA. Does it have anything to do with all my R&D pals being transferred to Ibn Baja? I've been wondering about...
In time, Dr. Lucas, everything will be revealed.
Sure. Yeah. There we are. Four biomes, four positives.
Finally. You have taken your time, Lucas.
I would have gone faster if you hadn't made me test these glove thingies for you. Can I finally take them off?
Yes, take them off, Nick. They're more valuable than you are.
Oh, all right. What was that, Supervisor? Huh? We're on first-name terms now?
Oh, Nick. We're not in any terms anymore. The terms of your contract have just expired.
Wait, what?
Why use a bioengineer to test gravitonic interfaces? That's for the higher-ups to know. But now that we're off the record, want to hear my best bet, Nick?
Do I?
I don't really care if you do. They needed you to test those biomes, Nick. And they wanted to make sure that Ibn Bajar shit will work in them.
Ibn Bajar? We have no domes in Ibn Bajar.
But now, the green thingies grow. The purple creeper works. Everything is on track. Just one loose end to tie. A mouthy engineer knows too much.
I don't know what you think you're doing, Engadji, but you better!
Hey, behind you.
Good job, Sergeant. Make sure your men take him to the composting unit. Yes, I have the reading from the thin of Ibn Bajar. After you do, the fire will be in your way. Oh, don't worry. I left no traces.